Hi, I'm Ben Brownlee for Boris Effect. Now, there are a lot of new things that are available in Silhouette 2023. So let's take a moment to take a quick look at some of the new features. Silhouette 2023 sees the introduction of our first AI and machine learning tools for generative AI with stability and grain management. There's a brand new denoiser, Denoiser ML, which gives fast AI-powered results to provide a smooth canvas to paint or composite on. On the other side of grain management, we have two new ways to add grain back in. Regrain samples the original plate's noise and adds this back to the final composite. Plus, the addition of Sapphire 2023.5 to Silhouette also gives us UltraGrain as an alternate way to create realistic-looking synthetic grain, with scores of presets based on popular camera sensors and film stocks. Primatte gives us powerful new keying capabilities with custom Boris Effects modules to quickly tackle tough shots, and they combine seamlessly with Silhouette's industry-standard roto tools. Silhouette's new expressions allows us to link parameters or auto-animate values, drag values for fast linking, or type out more complex multi-line ones. This is just a sampling of what's here, so stay with me as we go into more details. Now, the first shot we're looking at may give you a hint about one of the new features. If we take a look in the key category now, we have Primatte available as a new keyer. And all of these little buttons down here look very tempting, but we're not going to touch those yet because we need a background for Primatte. So this leads me actually on to the next feature that I want to talk about, which is some of the machine learning or AI tools that we have now available within side of Silhouette. And one of those is stability. So if I type in stability here, now, you may know stability.ai or Stable Diffusion, and this brings this directly inside of Silhouette for you. So there are three different modes that we can work with. We can use generate, inpaint, or outpaint. And it's as simple as this. If we're just wanting to generate up a background as we are in this case, I don't need to have anything piped into stability. I just need to type in a prompt. So I'll do commercial photograph of a dark bar with a neon blue light and a neon sign above the counter. We do have options here about what we want to do with it. And when I'm happy with this, I can just hit generate. And so long as we have our API key in the Silhouette preferences and some available credits, we're now going to go ahead and hallucinate or dream a few different versions for us. And we have, you know, a few different images that we can start to use. I will pipe in, well, let's just pipe in this one into our background. I can even actually add in, maybe I'll do a rack defocus or something. And let's head back into Primatte. Now with Primatte, most of the work is going to be done very interactively. So if you've ever used Primatte before, we know just to hit auto analyze. This will do most of the work for us. And then we can come up into the different viewers here and maybe do some tidying up directly on the viewer. So we're in clean background. We just clean the background up as we need it and change over to the other tools like clean foreground. Lovely. And then we can sort of take a look at the, you know, the final map that we have here just to see if we need to do anything else. And take a look at our final composite afterwards. You know, we have things like secondary spill built straight into the plugin. And, you know, we also have things like color correction built directly into the plugin as well. So if you just need to do some very straightforward little changes here, you know, you don't have to go out into a separate color correction node. We can do them all within the Primatte node if that's what you want. So coming to our next shot, I want to show you something else that we can do with stability. which isn't going across the entire frame. Because we can use stability to also do in painting. So if I pipe in a roto object that I have here, so I want to get rid of this foot that has decided to pop into our shot. We can get rid of this really, really easily using stability and in paint. Now with in painting, I don't even need to use a prompt. I can just leave it as it is and it will use the image to generate up what's happening and filling it. So really, I only have to decide how many images I want to choose from and then hit generate. If we want 4, we'll just hit generate. We'll wait a few seconds and then we come back with a few options for us. And looking back down here in the no parameters, we can choose between any of the ones that we have been generated up. Maybe I'll just take in this one here. And that's just a nice quick way of doing in painting. Knowing, of course, that at any point we could just change this up to a different sample and we can work through there. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is grain management. And there have been a number of new improvements within this sort of topic in Silhouette 2023, including the next part of our AI toolset. All right, so let's look at this shot here. I'm going to zoom in so we can really see what we're looking at. And maybe I'm just going to check out one of the color channels. So let's take a look at the red, green, red, green and blue. And they're all pretty horrible, to be fair. But we'll stick with the blue one for now, because I want to choose another one of our new filters. And I'm just going to type in denoise. And you'll notice that we now have a Denoiser ML. So this is Boris FX's first fully homegrown machine learning plugin. So let's add this in here. And immediately you can see the results. If I use the keyboard shortcuts 1 and 2, we can see the before and the after. Now, degraining is only the first half of the grain management workflow. Obviously, at the end of it, we need to regrain again, either to help to bring our composite together or to create a different style or match different cameras so that everything looks nice and unified. And we have a couple of different ways of doing that. The first one that I'm going to show you is our new regrain tool. Now, if we zoom in a little bit on here, we can see that there is an obvious difference between the original footage and our color bars. No matter which of the color channels we look at, we can see that there's a big difference between the two elements. So we have another new node, which is called Regrain. And Regrain needs 3 inputs. It needs our original plate, which is going to be our street here. And it needs a degrained version, which we can happily take from our denoiser. And it needs the composite, and the composite should come from a degrained version of it there. So that's why we'll now pipe in the denoised version into the composite. And if I come into Regrain now and hit analyze footage, it's going to have a little think and then come back with a regrained version that matches the grain on the original plate onto the composite. So if we take a little look now and look at the red, green and blue channels, you can see that the grain is matching across the different elements. We have that nice unified look that works even when we're in motion. So we can take a little look at that. Lovely. The other leg of our grain management stool is Sapphire UltraGrain. So we have our original shot, which is, you know, it has nice natural grain in there. And I've denoised this using the denoiser. Now, sometimes you might want to match different cameras together within the same scene. So having a consistent grain pattern is going to be very useful for you. Or you might want to add a stylistic look to your shots as well, you know, so that everything has a uniform grain pattern over the top. And that's where UltraGrain can come into it. So let's add in UltraGrain onto this shot. And most of the work with UltraGrain has actually already been done for you through the presets, because UltraGrain contains a large number of presets that go through some of the most popular cinema cameras, but also, you know, has a few more stylistic ones in here, also some popular film stocks as well. And I'll match this to a red helium. And let's find a color channel which actually reflects this a bit better. Most of the work is actually done for you, and all you really need to do is change up things like the grain amplitude and maybe the grain blur. And let's just do a side by side. So we take a look at the denoised version and the UltraGrain version. The UltraGrain looks pretty good against the original with just a tiny amount of tweaking. And we'll take a quick look at that in motion as well. You can see that, you know, the UltraGrain has captured a lot of that nice natural structure that we're looking for when we're looking for, you know, for realistic looking grain. Now, silhouette has been highly customizable right from the very start. But if you've been scared away from scripting because of its sort of perceived complexity, then expressions might be a nice, easy way for you to get into that sort of area. Because with expressions, what we can do is we can start linking parameters together or automating certain tasks. Well, let's take a quick look at this shot. We have a particle illusion on this shot here. As I said, we've got particle illusion 2023 in there. And all I've done is I've come in and I have keyframed up the number on the particles. So if we want to link parameters together, say for example we wanted to link the number to the zoom, so that instead of just sparking up as it does there, the particles grow as the number increases, all we have to do to link two parameters together is just drag from one, so I'm dragging from number onto the other one that we want to, so I'm dragging into zoom. And we take a little look there, we can see it's automatically written in a little expression for us. So zoom is the number of particles. Boom, boom, boom. So that's zooming in. We can even change these up as well. So if I want to use simple math just to bring this in, so maybe I'll do number of particles multiplied by 3. I can do that there. This is going to be quite big. So let's play that back. So you can see it grows and then shrinks back to where it was. Maybe we won't have 3, maybe we'll just do 2.5. And I can obviously do this to multiple parameters. So I can take my number, take it up to life. I could even take it up to velocity as well. So we have all of these 4 different areas here that are all being controlled by basically one set of keyframes. But we can go beyond basic math operators and do some other interesting things here. So we have a radial gradient, which I can just move around quite happily. Thank you very much. But I can also hook this up into a color correction, and then I can link these with some slightly more complex maths. So here I'm taking my gradient position X and then minusing the session width size. So dividing that by 2 to find the center, and minusing that, and then dividing the whole thing by 5. What does that do? Well, it means that as I move away from the center, I can start to change the color of a particular shape. I can also go a little bit further than that as well, and, you know, do that same expression as we had before, the radial gradient minus the session width divided by 2. But I can also wrap this in a little abs So absolute value. So that means all of the values that I get are going to be positive. So we can use, you know, again, simple Python math to help to drive this. And what that means is that as I move this away from the center, we also start blurring things out. So if I move it over to the right, we blur it and get it cyan. If we move it to the left, it blurs out and becomes yellow. You know, so we can start to manipulate properties in ways that we couldn't do before. So we've just taken a quick overview of some of the new features that are available in Silhouette 2023. We've had a look at Primatte, we've had a look at grain management and a little look at expressions as well. But there's a lot more that we have in this big, big update. So if you want to learn more about all the features and functionality that has been added to Silhouette 2023, or find out any more details about what you've just seen, then head straight over to the Boris FX website, borisfx.com, and you can find all the details there. You can also download a free trial version as well to test it all out for yourself. Of course, if you'd like to learn more, you'll also find a wealth of free tutorials to help you learn Silhouette and all of the Boris Effects products. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'll see you again soon. Bye for now.